The console wars are entering a whole new era in 2020, as we move on to the next generation of gaming and a massive tech giant enters the picture. But as a gamer, what new console do you choose? Or do you pick them all? Well, we made the choice even easier for you today, as we pit the PS5 up against the Xbox 2 and the Google Stadia in the ultimate battle of console domination. This isn't just about brand loyalty, as we break down gaming choices, features, graphics, and online interaction to determine the ultimate winner. Graphics comparisons. 4K graphics are the new standard in gaming, and this is the bare minimum that will be supplied by all three consoles. The one caveat? Internet speed. Playing a detail-rich game like Assassin's Creed Origins could look very different at one home using Stadia compared to another. The Google Stadia uses variable graphic performance based solely on internet speed. So if your parents are binge-watching Netflix while your little sister jams out to Spotify, you could easily find yourself playing a game at 720p with stereo sound instead of being maxed out at 4K graphics with HDR video and 5.1 surround sound. The PS5 and Xbox 2 will rely on discs and downloads to provide a consistent quality for a lot of the games. Besides the 4K quality, each of the three consoles also aim to provide 60 frames per second as a standard for a majority of the game. In simple terms, character movements are going to look incredibly smooth, things like car races are going to be fluid, and all those first-person shooters will be even better than you could imagine. Another way these consoles are all improving on the graphical presentation? With ray tracing. The lighting technique includes extremely vivid graphics, and will make everything from reflections to shadows look even more realistic than they already are. All in all, each console is pretty much on par with each other in the graphics department, with the PS5 and Xbox 2 taking a slight edge because of Stadia's reliance on proper internet speeds. The controllers. What are good graphics without a good controller to enjoy those games with? The PS5 and Xbox 2 both have a history of controllers their gamers are used to. While you can expect more of the same from Xbox with their Pro controller, Sony is making vast improvements for their next entry in the DualShock controller. One of the biggest features is a major upgrade in the rumble technology and the adaptive nature of the analog sticks. No longer will the controller just play out a random rumble or buzz while you play. Everything reacts to the surroundings you're in. If you're an undercover agent who must climb their way through a snowy mountainside, you'll feel the struggle of each footstep as you move the analog stick around. Driving a vehicle on a beach instead of the road? You'll feel the difference as you travel through sand as opposed to the paved road. On top of that, the trigger buttons on top of the newest DualShock controller are more sensitive than ever. Blasting your way through levels with a laser gun will feel very different than playing as Batman and throwing a batarang, and the pressure you place on the trigger will indicate the speed and force rather than just button mashing. Google Stadia isn't trying to reinvent the wheel with their controller either. Knowing what works, the Stadia controller features dual analog sticks, the typical input buttons, and multiple triggers on top. If the DualShock controller works without any major problems or glitches, then the PS5 edges out the competition for the innovative nature of their design. Cloud game services. And speaking of cloud-based gaming, Google Stadia is not the only one providing this streaming service. Besides their typical game releases and digital downloads, both Sony and Microsoft have their own subscription-based streaming game services. The Xbox Game Pass is priced at $10 a month and features over 100 games, with a rotating title of options including console classics. The xCloud service Microsoft runs on looks to expand the Game Pass to all types of iOS and Android devices in the near future. The PlayStation Now service has an affordable option if players are willing to pay for a whole year up front. While the base price starts at $9.99 per month, a whole year costs around $60, which equals out to $5 a month. The PS5 will be one of the best ways to enjoy the service, with a huge library of past games from the PS2, PS3, and PS4 all rolled into one. The cloud-based service also includes PC gaming through the PS Now app. The pricing discounts give the PlayStation Cloud streaming a huge plus. But the Xbox Game Pass does have some exclusive rights to Minecraft, so there's that. It's a little hard to compare Stadia's options until the service fully rolls out, but there will be a free plan, allowing gamers to hop on any Google device and play. The Pro plan will include a number of free monthly gaming options as well. Solid-state hard drives. The insides of both the Xbox 2 and PS5 will show a major improvement with solid-state hard drives. The massive improvement was years in the making, and the more affordable hard drives will be a game-changer in many ways. Load times will be virtually non-existent, and the struggles of saving hard drive space will be gone as well. With a solid-state drive, gamers don't need to download the whole game to play. Not interested in the single-player campaign? Just download the multiplayer element of the game and be on your merry way. Not only will you be able to save hard drive space, but the anticipation of playing a game will not take hours and hours. On the Google side of things, even though the Stadia platform will be available through the Chromecast Ultra and Chromebooks, there are no downloads needed. Everything will be cloud-based, saving some hard drive space and reducing loading times as Google's high-speed servers provide all the loading and space you need for a whole library of games. Game streams. In today's gaming world, does it even count that you've played a game if your epic skills or epic fails were not captured in some sort of game stream? Well, that's pretty much the case, and live game stream focus has been an emphasis for all the next-gen consoles. Microsoft is getting pretty serious about their online streaming platform Mixer. The newest competitor to Twitch will be integrated directly into the Xbox too, making it easy for players to hop online and broadcast their live streams. A picture-in-picture format also allows players to watch Mixer streams while they play their own games. Plus, Ninja has joined the Mixer party, giving the whole service a lot of legitimacy and fanfare.
I will be streaming exclusively on Mixer.
Sony does not have their own streaming service, but Twitch is readily available for the console, and will likely make the same transition with the PS5. Meanwhile, the powerhouse of Google has one of the most popular video streaming websites at its fingertips in the form of YouTube. With a capture button featured on the Stadia controller, players will easily be able to sort out content, upload footage, and create all types of Stadia YouTube content. The YouTube integration is huge for Stadia, but the Xbox Mixer service may edge them all out. Ninja has garnered a ton of press for his Switch, and by the time the Xbox 2 gets released, the platform could have an even larger viewing audience. Online play. With cloud-based games, huge downloads, and an emphasis on services like Xbox Live and PlayStation Plus, online gaming will be bigger than ever in the next generation of consoles. And Google has announced some pretty innovative changes that will help set the Stadia apart. The first is the Buddy Pass. Sick of having a friend who doesn't have the online subscription you want to play with? Well, just gift them one with a Buddy Pass. Anyone who signs up for Stadia's Founders Package will be allowed to give someone a Buddy Pass for 3 months, and that player can reap all the benefits. Another feature that helps the Stadia stand out above the rest? The Crowdplay feature. Enjoying your favorite streamer in a popular multiplayer game? Well, the Crowdplay feature allows you to hop in on their actual game, giving gamers a chance to play with some of their favorites. For PS5 and Xbox 2, expect more of the same. Not that it's a bad thing, but Google's major changes could lead to some new innovations for both Microsoft and Sony. Give one to the new guy, because Google's online play definitely piques a lot of interest. Enjoying the battle so far? Well, be sure to check out our video 10 Worst Gaming Injuries when you're done. Free games! Who doesn't love free games? Well, we're here to give you a breakdown of all the best free options for each of the next-gen consoles. Google is on the short end of the stick here as they rely on players making full game purchases rather than offering a whole lot of free titles. So far, the only free game packaged with the Stadia Premier Edition is Destiny 2 The Collection. Meanwhile, you can expect both PlayStation Plus and Xbox Gold to continue rolling out their free game options. The free games have been a huge highlight to paying the monthly subscriptions on both systems, and removing the feature would likely result in a lot less subscribers. The free game feature is an ideal way for third-party and independent publishers to showcase a variety of their games, and gives players an easy way to build up their library. Google definitely has a lot of catching up to do in the free game department, but the company is also working on publishing their own games, so there could be some major changes and more access to games down the line. Backwards compatibility. Google is the little baby among the bunch. Unless they decide to connect to services like Epic Games or Steam, do not expect a huge back library of game downloads and backwards compatibility. Meanwhile, Microsoft and Sony will continue to honor their faithful, making you want to dust off some discs in the long run. Sony will allow any PS4 disc to work on the console, giving players a lot of time to stack up on games over the next year. Meanwhile, the Xbox 2 might as well be called the Xbox Legacy, because the console really blows all the others out of the park with its physical disc compatibility. The console will be able to read every single Xbox game from the original console all the way up to the Xbox One. This is a huge feature, and will likely have us on eBay snatching up old games we used to love. Needless to say, but the Xbox 2 has the major advantage in this category. Other forms of media. While we all love our hours and hours of gaming marathons, consoles have become a lot more than just gaming machines. So let's take a look at some of the extras. Anyone who purchases the Stadia Premier Edition will get a Chromecast Ultra, the HDMI device which offers streaming access to hundreds of different channels along with some live TV options like Sling. Naturally, both the Xbox and PlayStation will continue their wide range of streaming channels like Netflix, Hulu, and newer options like Disney+. On the Xbox side of things, the exclusive NFL content will help draw in sports fans. Meanwhile, Sony continues to promote their live TV service, PlayStation View. The View is available on multiple devices, making it an option for when the PS5 is not in use. Expect the expansion of the View service on the PS5 with some possible added features and extra content. No matter what type of video streams you enjoy, all the consoles are pretty much equal in this category. Release dates. Okay, now that we all know about the newest consoles, it's pretty much a race to the finish line to see which ones will get released first. Well, Google has a head start as the premier edition of Stadia will roll out in November. Although there has been some major delays due to the pre-orders selling out across the globe.
That Stadia is launching this year, 2019.
No matter when the various forms Google Stadia pre-orders do arrive, it will be months in advance of the PS5 and Xbox One. The Sony and Microsoft consoles are set for a holiday 2020 launch date, giving Google plenty of time to work out the kinks, build up on the hype, and allow Stadia to become a household name. The latest rumor points to the Sony PS5 getting released on December 4th, 2020, just in time to place a big old box under the Christmas tree. Let's just say that Christmas break 2020 will be filled with a whole lot of games. Wow, what a battle between some juggernauts! The cloud service streaming definitely limits Stadia's presence in the console wars, but the ability to play on a Pixel 4 also changes gaming forever. Microsoft and Sony are sure making some major improvements, but time will only tell when people finally get some hands-on action with the consoles. Either way, we're all excited for the next generation of gaming. And now it's your turn. Which console has impressed you the most so far? What features are you looking forward to? Anything great we missed? Well, let us know in the comments, and stick around The Gamer for more great video game content. We're releasing new videos every couple of days. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to stay up to date with our channel.